first and probably the only forum that will focus on East Harlem.
Yeah,
because we are here and we're in the building. So thank you for showing up on this rainy, cold night, because you could have stayed home and it would have looked like we didn't care. So thank you, community, for turning out. My name is Sade Lithcott. I am the CEO of Dr. Barbara Antier's National Black Theater. It's my brother, Michael Lithcott, who's the chairman of our board. And so I want to welcome you in the words of our mother, the founder of National Black Theater. Welcome to your home away from home. I'm sure I see so many familiar faces, so welcome back. And if this is your first time coming to NBT, welcome home. Lastly, I'll say, NBT has been here for almost a half a century. We are celebrating our 48th anniversary. And our mother knew that this corner, Fifth Avenue, the east side of Harlem, Fifth Avenue and 125th Street, was the most important address in the world. She said, Fifth Avenue, opulence, 125th Street, Harlem, black culture, right? So we wanted to build this institution, this temple, for the culture of our community. And in saying that, we have wonderful programs and productions. I hope you will come back to see a play. Our show Manhood opens up on the 8th of this month, Black History Month. And I'm going to hand over this forum, because it's not about us, to, is Carrie gonna speak on behalf of Nima? Great. So this couldn't have come together without our organizing partners, Nima and Uptown Red Central, being one of them.
Thank you so much, Ade. Thank you, Michael. This is so thrilling to see such a full house here in East Harlem. I'm not going to take up too much time, but I just want to say this night would not be possible without a whole bunch of people. One group is our board, the NEMA Uptown Grand Central Board. If you are on the board, would you please stand? NEMA Uptown Grand Central is a coalition of small businesses, arts institutions, healthcare institutions, and neighbors along East 125th Street and Park Avenue, working to make this side of town a better place, making Uptown Grand, and we're glad to have you be a part of it. Also, I want to thank all of these neighborhood partners that you can see up here on the wall. If you are one of our neighborhood partners, please stand. I would call you all out, but I know you want to get candidates. We're going to leave that screen up so you can see all these wonderful groups that are working together and submitted questions. Randy will explain a little bit later, but not only did individuals in our neighborhood submit questions, but organizations did as well. And we've done our best to combine them and pull the themes out so that we can get you guys answering what's important to East Harlem. So with that, I'm going to turn it over to Randy.
Okay, guys, so we're going to start really quickly with an introduction from each candidate. It'll be 1 minute. And because it's a special election, we would ask you to start with your name, your political party of record, that is Democrat, Republican, Independent, or other, and then a brief statement explaining why you are uniquely qualified for this position. So we can start at the end with several of us.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Can you hear me in the back without this?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. No. So, thank you. So, I am a native New Yorker, a resident of this district, and been living in this neighborhood, serving in this neighborhood from the perspective of a neighborhood leader to a Democratic district leader to an elected official to a tenant leader, and I have a record of addressing issues in this neighborhood effectively, whether it was lead paint poisoning, infant mortality, as well as issues related to changing the tone of the neighborhood in terms of the kind of activity that sometimes takes place on the streets that we don't like. And I believe that my record of accomplishment has been one that speaks succinctly to the needs of the neighborhood, and I look forward to your support to continue in that vein. Thank you very much.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Marlon Holland.
Good evening.
Thank you. I happen to live right across the street at 1919 Madison Avenue. My wife is here. Why I'm running and to get to the point is, I think Harlem needs a change and some new leadership. And I think I am that person. I've been a transit worker for over 25 years. I became the political director. director about 5 years ago, and I've been able to get a lot of stuff done legislatively, policy-wise, for my union, and I want to bring the skills I've learned as a political director over to the community of Harlem, which I really think needs to be unified and learn to work together. Thank you, and I look forward to the forum tonight.
Good evening, my name is Cordell Clear. I'm a Democrat. My beginnings as a resident of this community, I'll start with that, and living through some very difficult times in this community, I've seen Harlem come out of a very dark period into a better period. My focus is making sure that many of us who lived here as organizers, elected or not, who organized and protected and preserved the property, preserved the buildings, protected our community and stayed here and fought, ran businesses, raised our children, that there is an opportunity for us to remain as we welcome newcomers as well. My focus, why I think that I'm qualified, is my service in government for over 19 years. I'm a former staff person to Senator Perkins. I'm also a district leader I've served as. I sat on my school board for 8 years, the Community Education Council. I've organized coalitions across this city to combat circumstances that I was living in. Okay, sir, it's time for me to stop.
You can wrap up at the end.
I can wrap it up, okay. And successfully passed historic legislation in 2004 in this community that has saved thousands of lives.
Thank you.
I think this qualifies me to serve our community.
Good evening, Harlem. Good evening, Harlem. I'm Larry Scott Blackman, and I am a candidate for city council. It's a joy and a pleasure to be here with you tonight. I'm running for city council for one main reason, because I have the community's interests at heart, not special interests at heart. I was born in this community. I grew up in this community. I was raised in Drew Hamilton Houses on 141st Street. I never forgot Harlem, no matter where I went. When I came back and worked in government, I worked for the New York City Department of Parks. And what did I do? I helped save the fire watchtower in Marcus Garvey Park. We brought money home to have that watchtower taken down and given the proper restoration that it deserves. I even have a confession to make. Nima, I go get my hair cut at Harlem Berry right on 125th between 5th and Madison. So all those beautiful tree pits that you had installed on 125th Street, I hired the exact same vendor, brought them to the South Bronx. And when you walk down 138th Street, you'll see that vendor from right on 116th Street and Park Avenue. His work and the work of that community, of this community, has now spread out. So I'm someone who understands government, who knows how to get things done, and I look forward to having your support on September 14th. I look forward to this discussion. Thank you.
Okay, quickly, because I'm going to have Todd Stevens, representative, come up and give a brief introduction.
Good evening. My name is Shakia Cherry Donaldson, and I'm here on behalf of candidate Todd Stevens, who unfortunately, because we're seven days away, is at another event this evening. But I knew that in this place and in this time, he and his wife needed to come and speak on his behalf. Much like the candidates here, Todd was called to serve. He spent 15 years in Harlem providing homes for over 500 residents here in our neighborhood. He and his wife have a beautiful daughter, Chloe. He's vested in his faith and in his community. But last November, after how the election went, he knew that it was time to step up and do more. So he's running for District 9 City Council this February 14th. And we thank you for your support, for all those who have heard our message and our call. And we look forward to getting out into the streets and telling everyone how Todd plans to improve housing, but not only just affordable housing, but creating pathways for people to have home ownership in this community. How charter school or traditional public school, it doesn't matter. Every child deserves a high quality education because no student should be left behind. And that no matter whatever your gender is, your age is, or your love preference, that you should be able to walk down the streets of Harlem and feel safe every day. So thank you so much for your time. We look forward to seeing you at other events and have a great night. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Athena Moore, candidate for New York
New City Council. And I'm a people person, okay? And I'm blessed and grateful to be here on this evening for many reasons. For one, Barbara Ann Teer and her legacy here at National Black Theater. This is where I've been holding my Kwanzaa 30 years now in Harlem, and I'm blessed to be at the helm here in your mother's grace and presence. I am also the former director of the Manhattan Borough President's Office on 125th Street. So I feel that I am entirely prepared. I've been on the ground doing the work, helping with constituent services, with affordable housing, with education, making sure that healthcare is prioritized, and making sure that our community has jobs. I will continue to do that through my candidacy. I grew up in public housing in NYCHA. I also came from a mother who was mentally ill and a father who passed away from substance abuse. My father passed away after the war when he couldn't return and get a job, and our family disintegrated. But I'm not here to tell you about doom and gloom. Trump has already done that. I'm here to bring you light, to bring vibrancy, to bring a change, and to make sure that we know that Harlem is not falling, but Harlem is rising. And I will continue to advocate for you. I'm a policy advocate. I will use my voice. I have budget, policy, land use, decision-making experience, and over 20 years expertise. I started my journey in the Bronx Borough President's Office 20 years ago. I went to Congress and worked for a congressman there. I went into the nonprofit sector as an executive director at United Way, at the Protestant Federation, and at the National Association for Social Workers. So I'm a person who knows the needs of this community. I am Harlem. My father lived in Harlem, and I was one of those who couldn't stay in Harlem because the rents are too damn high. I also want to tell you that I'm not a career politician. I'm not here trying to make sure that we have community needs being met. And my time is here, so thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Please give us questions so we have enough time for all the questions, and everyone should get their 2 cents, please.
Good evening, Harlem.
Good evening,
Harlem.
Good evening.
I'm Charles Cooper. I'm a Democrat, and I look forward to being the next city council person for this district. I start off with my background. I come from a very humble background. At 12 years old, my father woke me up in the middle of the night. It was the start of a civil war in Liberia. He packed my mother and my 2 sisters and sent us to Sierra Leone. When violence threatened us here, we then fled to the U.S. I grew up in public housing, didn't get to see my father until I was 22. But I'm more than just that. I'm also a owner of a Harlem-based infrastructure firm called Aerial. I'm also a community board member, vice chair of Community Board 9. And one of the things we've done on Community Board 9 was restructure the West Harlem Development Corporation. What that did was provide millions of dollars to non-for-profit organizations. Another initiative we worked on is to create and increase the goal to women and minority-owned contracts with respect to state and city businesses. And I look forward to talking more about this and engaging you in further discussion. Thank you for your time.
Hi, my name is Dr. Caprice Alves. I have a doctorate degree in executive leadership and social justice. I'm in this race because, and actually, I jumped into this race last minute. It took me 4 days to get on the ballot. It took me 2 days or 3 days to fight back the challenge. Somebody tried to knock me off the ballot. I survived that too, so I guess I'm here to stay, and I guess it's meant to be. I jumped into this race because a constituent came to me after they exhausted all of their resources and went to everybody else because their son was sitting in Rikers Island for almost 3 years. It took me to step in, follow the case, help the family, go to court and realize the root cause was human error, human ineptness, and after that, the son ultimately stayed in jail for 4 years and then in 1 day was vindicated and found not guilty. That's why I jumped into this race, because I feel like there's nobody sometimes to call except me. I depend on me, and I'm a role model for this community. I'm the face of overcoming adversity, fighting back bullying. It's okay to be educated, it's okay to be a homeowner, and it's okay to want to lead your community, and that's what I'm here to do. Thank you.